And now the high point of the Provincetown Film Festival, and he's not even on film, he's just on video here. It's Scott Cunningham of Scott Cake Store.
Hey, hello, Stephen. How are you? It's so good to see you.
It would not be one film festival without you. I was like, where are you? I got my flag going.
I know. We're letting our pink flag fly. Scott Cakes. We're here at Scott Cakes.
Yeah, we're at Scott Cakes. I'm still making those damn pink cupcakes. And people
are. But I came here yesterday, and I kept coming back, and you weren't here. And finally, you're here. I was so frustrated.
I had my helper. I had to give her a day off. I've been working on. We're shipping nationally. People
of
are like,
you
well,
are.
They want them, so I'm like, all right, let's.
You'll be a franchise before you know it.
And I'm not a. It's you know, it's it wasn't my plan. Not my plan.
Well, can I tell you what happened to B? Did you know B Chamberlain from, El Mundo?
Yeah.
She's now like a franchise in Kentucky, a millionaire's.
You're kidding me.
She's got five or more Taco Bells.
El Mundo Bells
going on all over Kentucky.
So that's why they left. See, I didn't know the whole story. So you know better.
She's a millionaire.
You know better Provincetown gossip
I'm guessing she's a millionaire. She's certainly got a lot of business.
Well, good for her. They deserve it.
And if you want that, I don't know if you want that.
Yeah, why not? I got to do something. Yeah, I'm getting, I'm pushing it. I can't stand up for 12 hours a day anymore. It's good though.
I can't stand up for 12 seconds a day anymore.
Well.
You notice we're sitting down, but anyway, we're outside of
I don't
Scott
have any, Cakes. I have no cupcakes for you to eat.
I'm not supposed to eat them, but he wants to.
No, Jack, believe me, you can have plenty.
We'll be getting cupcakes.
I need to get Deborah Winger a cupcake because she is.
Deborah Winger's here.
I love her. I really just. She's a never give up. She's a unique never give up.
She's scary to me.
I love her. Oh my God.
But she's probably very nice to talk to.
Oh, look at her. She's amazing. Yeah. She needs to have a cupcake.
She's a great actress.
Joan Rivers is going to have a cupcake. She's into town next week.
Is she starting to look like Chelsea Handler? Is that my imagination?
No. Chelsea Handler is starting to look like her.
Oh, okay. I knew you had the taste.
Yeah,
I know he said he did nothing to talk about. Well,
they're actually, I think they're actually lovers. I think that whole fighting is a front. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Her and Joan.
I tried to get Joan to be, on Saturday Night Live, and so I started a whole campaign on YouTube.
Uh-huh. Went nowhere.
NBC still didn't want her.
That's crazy.
But she has been a guest on the Jimmy Fallon show.
Oh, she has. Okay, yeah.
Jimmy Fallon, the nervous wreck with the talk show. I don't know. He makes me nervous.
He does those fun songs and I watched that Elmo one over and over again.
Really?
Oh my God.
Really?
Oh yeah, okay. It's crazy. I love it.
So how have you been last year? Oh, I'm so mad at you. Last year you got married. You said you were going to send me all these beautiful pictures.
And you did. And I have them, and then you don't understand. Stephen, I am the king of ADD. Like, I am not.
I thought you were the king of Scott Cakes.
Oh, I'm the cupcake man.
Yeah.
But I have. Yeah, I go into. I'm like, oh yeah, great. You should. Oh my God. So I just hired an assistant, and things are getting done. I'm back there making the frosting, and she's making sure that people get responded to.
Did I meet her? Was that the?
No. I have someone. She lives in Boston. Her name is Wendy. And she's like my new,
Wendy Cupcake.
She's like my newest savior. We're supposed to save ourselves, but I need a little.
We need some help.
I need a little saving, Stephen. I really do. That's why it's so.
Why?
It's so
you're
out of my mind. I'm the
Cupcake King, Scott Cakes.
I love it.
You're synonymous with Provincetown. I hope the Stephen Holt show has helped that.
I'd love it.
International visibility.
Well, Stephen, you are who you are. I mean,
And you are
Mr. Oscar.
I'm so happy to see you. So now you had to ask me the Oscar questions. Well, I haven't seen any of these films.
Well, I was
going to
say, so what have you seen? I don't even know what's going on. And can Angelina get nominated?
For Maleficent. I started that rumor. Thank you for spreading.
Well, I would like to get behind that because I've seen it twice.
Thank you.
And it's a mediocre, one of the greatest performances on film in a mediocre overdone film.
Well, did you see it in IMAX 3D?
I did. And then I saw it at the drive-in because I was driving when it was playing. I was like, I need to go see her again. Because when are you going to see that kind of
performance? It's so campy. It's just such a gay movie.
But she's so rooted in.
She's so.
There's no one like. Who has ever been like her? What, Betty Davis? But she didn't have the range. as much as Angelina.
And the green flame is rising behind her.
Yeah, I mean, like, come on.
Maleficent is the movie. Disney has done it again. I have to say that that is totally a possibility. She could get a nomination for that.
They don't like to nominate people in movies that are mediocre, though. They need it to be a great, great movie, and it's not a great, great movie.
It's doing great box office.
Oh, sure. I went to go see it twice, and I knew it wasn't that it's not a great movie. It's a world-class performance.
I loved it.
Oh, I did, too. I loved it. Anytime she was on, oh, my God, riveted.
Yes, and I felt her performance overcame the special effects and the 3D.
Well, I thought it made the other, like, the little prancing trolls and whatever look, like, you know, ridiculous.
Like trolls.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot of trolls on the internet. Watch out. But anyway... So I never got any pictures of your marriage. Our viewers, I waited and waited, and I held the show back, and I just edited.
I'm ADD. I need help, and now I have help.
Are we going to get any pictures this
Yes,
year?
Because now she has the disc.
And even though Scott got married last year, we will look forward to
it. It doesn't
to
matter.
Pictures.
I haven't even seen my husband since then, so it doesn't even, you know, I've been making the cupcakes. Well, he lives in D.C., and I'm here. We're like, you know, half the year I'm there.
Well, that's good.
It still feels like, you know.
So you missed the horrible winter.
It's new. I did. It was cold down there, but not like here.
It must have been awful here. But you skipped it and you were in D.C. Well, that you were safe.
Yeah. Yeah, it was good.
With your husband, no less. That's lovely.
Yeah. Yeah, it's
DC
very nice.
In the winter with your husband sounds divine.
Yeah, it was good. We moved. We moved from one place to, you know, from in the city to a little bit outside.
You've been busy.
Busy.
And then you come back here and you just...
And I make buttercream.
You said you had nothing to talk about. You haven't stopped talking for. I never got a word in edgewise. I love it, Scott Cunningham at Scott Cakes all year. I look forward to this.
I'm so happy to see you.
Maleficent, but
I don't know.
I
just went last night to the drive-in again. That's why.
Well, coming up, the Beatles' Hard Day's Night has been remastered. It's here. Uh-huh. It's wonderful to see it again. I love it. I'm raving already. I mean, I saw it in New York. One Chance is in a film by the Weinsteins, of the Weinstein Company, about the guy who was on Britain's Got Talent, who was he wasn't a coal miner, but he was, you know, he won, and it was like this sad sack, and he wins, and it's inspirational, and it's played by James Corden, who won the Emmy for Best Actor. He took it away from Philip Seymour Hoffman
for what?
One Man, Two Governors, and he won.
Look, Scott Cakes. My cameraman, Jack, looks so hungry. I'm going to hand him.
Now there's a segue. Now there's a segue.
I'm good.
Oh, my God.
Good.
Once a year, I let myself go wild.
You do, and you really do only have it. That's you're very good. You're very good. I haven't changed a thing. I think we should let Jack should have his.
Oh, he's eating it madly now. The camera just devoured it. So how's your husband?
He's great. He's great. He's going to be up here next week and we get to spend some time. Thanks, Sherry. Look, the customers. It's the customers at Scott Cakes. Get a shot, Jack. The customers at Scott Cakes. Look, helping themselves. Ladies and gentlemen, that is world famous artist Sherry Mittenthal. Yeah, huh? Thank you very much.
In New York, they do that, but they don't leave you.
Well, they don't leave the money. Well, this is Provincetown, you know.
So, you're back. You're bigger than ever.
Yeah, we're looking forward to a really busy season. So people are so happy. It's already busy in town, and you know, really, the theater festival is kind of the first, the theater festival, the film festival is the first, you know, sort of entry week into the start of the season, really.
Not Memorial Day?
Memorial Day comes, it's big, and then it's gone.
Not yeah, baby dyke
it's week. Huge, lots of baby dykes, but then everyone leaves, and then it's sort of like dead again until now, so.
And then the stars arrive this week.
I need to meet Deborah Winger. You need to hook me up. Are you interviewing her?
Mm-hmm.
Can I bring her? I will not bother her. I will say, because it's the official, Scott Cakes are the official dessert of Provincetown. I will bring her a cupcake, and that's all I will do. And because that's what I do for so many people.
Well, you can
I won't talk to her. I won't bug her.
Saturday at noon at Land's End.
Okay.
See if they let you in. It's for a lot of pink.
Oh yeah, I'll do the whole the whole thing. The official welcome, you know.
Don't you get sick of pink? I never get sick of pink.
But. No, because I don't have to look at it. You know, I just have to make it and wear it.
And every year, you're threatening to do chocolate cupcakes.
And now I'm not even. Now I'm not even threatening it.
You know, you're just lazy.
And limited.
Limited.
Yeah, yeah. It's really
it's
chocolate it's the laziness. It's a little bit of the laziness, but it's really coupled with the lack of talent. It's really
you mean
the thing
talent.
That's holding me back.
I don't think so. It is. At all.
I do this one thing, and that's that's it, and it's part of the brand now.
You created a magic formula for that pink.
And and getting lightning to hit to strike twice, that can be tough.
I get lightning to strike every week at midnight on channel 56. I've been doing it for 26 and a half years.
And it's your saying, and you do your thing. You do,
Yes, I do. And I keep doing it, whether anyone wants me to or not. I hope they do.
Of course.
It's so wonderful to see
it's
you.
So good. It really is so good to see you.
Instead of just watching you on my television all year long. He's always camera ready, ladies and gentlemen. I just kidnapped him off the street. Where were you coming from?
The post office. I had a delivery.
Oh.
Yeah. Had to ship some cupcakes to York, Pennsylvania.
My favorite spot.
I've never been.
Well, so what else is coming up at the film festival? A lot of stuff.
What is happening? What should I see? I know nothing.
Don't
I haven't looked at anything.
Venus in Furs. Please skip that one. It's Roman Polanski ruining a Broadway hit play that should have had a young 20-year-old girl in it. But he put his 40-year-old wife in it as a young 20-something actress scrambling for work in the rain with a wonderful performance by two people in the whole movie. Mathieu Amalric as the frazzled director has to put up with this chick. Mm-hmm. And his wife, Emmanuel Seigneur is a beautiful woman, but she's not a teenager. So it's like a little what are you doing here? Mm-hmm. She's trying to do something she can't, which is be young, which is what that play needed.
We try,
and you've got.
I have to say hi to customers. Hi, ladies.
Who are coming in and raiding your store? I guess I better say. We'll pause and hopefully come back maybe after I've seen a few movies.
We won't say goodbye. We'll just say.
A bientôt.
Exactly. Farewell. Adieu.
Adieu, as the French say. Au revoir. Merci beaucoup.
So it really is so awesome to see you. And Jack, eat your cupcake.
Have a fabulous